I'll call the meeting of April 16th, 2019 of the Ad Hoc Rules of Procedure of the Town Council Committee meeting to order. It is 9:32 a.m. Who's taking minutes today? Was it supposed to be Shalini? That would be my guess, but I do to do.
It might be me.
Right, it wasn't really,
it
just looks different. It's not actually much different in the terms and content. I know that we're sensitive to Kathy leaving, but let's try and see if meetings is as close as we think it is. And actually, somebody from IT may come up and help us. Got all different kinds of things on the screen now. Look at this. Isn't this fancy?
Oh,
I've never
seen. I gave you all the
fast. That's Mandy Jo.
That's the
doing her IT thing.
Oh, I definitely, can you even read it?
It's a try.
Yeah.
I mean, we can get it a little bigger.
So we can in a moment, IT will come, or half hour, IT will come up and go, wow, Mandy Jo, that's awesome. So the document we should be looking for is at this moment. Finding, Sean says he's finding the wire. Starburst to show that it's newer.
It's the new and improved version.
Starburst version, yes.
Okay.
Not the Skittles version. Taste the rainbow.
I looked at this quickly and I'm basically fine with it, so I won't make any comments. Because what the main changes as I saw them was that you put the references to charter and the general laws, and then you broke up minutes to have each of the content pieces be line items, like date, time, and place, correct?
Yes. Hey, Sean. We realized since we had an audience, maybe this was the time to figure out how to do this. Look what Mandy Jo did already. She's so awesome.
Okay. Yeah, that works. Do you want to go with that, or do you want to?
So what can we do with that? So you signed in over there as you. And you can be signed in as both of you. I mean, you can be signed on
on
your own device.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
So we had two questions. Will this completely swivel if we were trying just to show it to them? And then can we get the extension? Mandy figured out how to log in here by herself.
Yep.
As herself. But if any of us wanted to run off our laptops where we had
how would that work?
From this, yeah.
From
we're
this.
Looking at getting, yeah, because there's no.
So we don't have board. Any cable port in our.
Yeah.
Us.
So we have a wireless way of doing it that we haven't.
Okay.
We haven't actually tried out. If you want to do it right now,
let's give it a shot.
If you don't mind.
Can we just assuming it? Yeah, it won't take forever.
So
we'll give it a shot.
So you, in order to do this, you need to be on the Wi-Fi, which I'm.
Yeah,
which we
are. And if you go to your web browser and you type in that 192.168.10.228. See what it does here. Yeah.
So do
Okay.
So if you want to hit on that. And we started writing out.
So where did she put this?
So right in the browser, so right where it says AmherstMA.SharePoint. Just right in the address.
Oh, God. Oh, way up here. I see.
Yep.
I got as far as, because I was just seeing how far I could get with it before I started to mess things up. So now I just need the key, but we're going to see what happens if we both type this in.
Yeah, so 2129, it was up there for a moment. So
yeah, I saw it up there.
Yep. So I don't know.
Wow, that's
loud. User connected.
And I'm also connected. So in theory, we could all be connected and switch
so
back
I
and
wonder,
forth what
so
we were
if
doing.
You're seeing our is that from here?
And then I did this.
So yeah, if you click desktop, I'm guessing you will probably knock her off, but we haven't had a chance to see what happens.
And look down at the bottom. How
okay.
Two keys.
Yep. So I wonder if.
So now.
So it looks like.
So I'd like to give Kathy control.
Yeah. So she has control right now.
Okay. Kathy's in control right now. Good.
Okay, I'm going to stay in control.
Yes.
Andy is, what we just realized is that the online, we're going to have lots of feedback on SharePoint, John.
Yeah.
But one of the things is, here is a document that on SharePoint, its Word version shows no track changes.
Okay.
So the only way to see track changes is download
go
the document
into the actual,
and look at it.
Yeah.
Which, if you're working in real time,
you don't need to download it, you just need to open it in Word.
But if you open it in Word. Nope. But not if you open it in SharePoint. Not if you just
look, but what happens when you hit open in Word right there, above the bold symbol?
So is some of this might be the result of the permissions as well? That you can.
Right, and seeing what it looks like. Because, right now, right? So we can all look at the one in SharePoint, but if we hit open in Word, I guess we get the error message that Kathy got.
Okay, so I'm just going to stay here.
So I think that's a permission thing, I think, that we can look at. But.
Yes.
Yeah, so you
downloaded
it.
Yeah.
Okay, fine.
I just hit open in Word and it let me open it. So, who knows? It's interesting. So, gentlemen out in the audience, another way. We don't actually have printed agendas right now because this is the kind of thing that's not the public's coming in to tell us about something. We're talking about a new policy. We're basically editing a document. And so, there is a posted agenda to make it legally compliant. So, if you're on the town website, amherstma.gov, There's a calendar near the bottom, and on that calendar with today's date shows our open meeting law compliant list of topics, which basically says we're editing documents that are focused on a couple of separate issues, including meetings of committees. So the difference here is largely, I'm very sorry that there's some formatting stuff there because I screwed that up. But in terms of what I did substantively is down under content of minutes, so if you can scroll down to 3.5, I just broke it out. And what I was trying to do, I added the, I should back up. So where it says 3.5 minutes, we don't have to say of council meetings. I was doing that to keep myself straight. But it says minutes of council meetings shall comply with the general laws, the CMR reference that Kathy looked up for us, and the charter, including but not limited to the following. And the reason I did that is because if you'll remember way back, my initial concern was we mixed a bunch of things together in a text paragraph, some of which were required by the charter, some of which were required by Mass General Law, and some of which were just our standard practice. And rather than putting a parenthesis behind each one, I wanted to break them out and say they come from a variety of sources. So date, time, and place of meeting is absolutely required by that, you know, for example. So I don't think, you know, that's why I did it that way. And then adoption and publication of minutes is actually called out in the charter as one of the things in the rules. So I decided just carry it over, and it shows the dates that we chose the last time.
So did anything get changed substantively by doing this?
I see a few. I see one, mainly. But I would get rid of the including but not limited to the following. It's just kind of weird because then it goes to this A and then B. So I would just end the sentence after charter. And then have A, you could have more minimum content of minutes if you wanted. But I think it's fine. And in F, the all votes taken during any meeting, which remember that's added, I don't think it needs to be contained in this section. It's covered in other sections of the rules.
Wait, it absolutely needs to be in the minutes section.
Which one are you doing, G or F?
A, F?
It's the second half of F. All votes taken during any meeting in which a member participates remotely shall be by roll call vote.
That's G.
Oh, G to me is a list of documents and other exhibits.
A is date and time, B is term of search present, C is summary.
Oh, sorry, when I deleted it, maybe it deleted the G to H.
So I really disagree because I need us to be able to, I think we have a philosophical difference in terms of what this document is good for. This document, to me, needs to be good for somebody who's taking minutes. They need to be able to look at this and see exactly what they need to include. They don't need to remember that there's another section that might cover that. This is absolutely the minimal information in our minutes.
The content of minutes, F says each vote. So the G is
how you
is a method of collecting the votes. It's not the content.
It is content of minutes. All votes taken. You have to have a roll call vote in your minutes. If you didn't see that, if you don't include that in here, and you're doing a remote participation, and you're being a minutes taker, you don't know that remote participation also says you have to have roll call votes.
But the minutes taker isn't the one that needs to call for the roll. It's the presiding chair that calls for.
But the
roll.
Minutes need to reflect the roll call vote.
So it should be reworded then, because this wording to me is how you conduct the meeting, not how you record the minutes. So you can reword this.
Okay, that's fine.
Roll call votes shall be recorded in the minutes.
But that doesn't say that.
But we don't only do roll calls for remote participation.
But it's absolutely demanded that there's a roll call for remote participation.
And so there is for other things too. Are we going to call out every single thing that requires a roll call vote?
So you're just going to depend on people to read that other section of the rules?
For how you conduct a meeting, yes.
That doesn't reflect what ends up in the minutes.
So what ends up in the minutes is that a roll call vote occurred.
So what didn't end up in the minutes when Margaret was taking our minutes is she didn't include the names of all the people who voted for and against when we had a split vote because she wasn't familiar with that provision of the charter. So
that's F.
Right, because we didn't have that rule. But if we wouldn't have needed to write that here, because I just feel like a lot of this is oriented toward hey, we covered it someplace, as opposed to, can we make it useful for people actually doing the work?
But this, my problem is it calls out only one thing you might do a roll call vote for, which is incomplete. If you're going for complete, you should call out everything you're doing a roll call vote for, or just say,
how about
roll call votes need recorded as roll call votes in the minutes, period, without specific instances that you take a roll call vote.
So it, can you phrase it in such a way, maybe you can do this later then, you can, if, phrase it in such a way that makes it clear that roll calls are not optional, that it's that under some circumstances, I know you want to flip it the other way, under some circumstances roll call votes are required. You don't want to list out what all those circumstances are, but you want to say that when they are required, they'll be recorded in the minutes.
Okay,
is that what you're
so
saying?
You could just say when the roll call vote is required, it shall be recorded in the minutes.
Yes. Okay.
Or
something like that.
All roll call votes shall be recorded.
Because
it
somebody might call for a roll call vote as an optional one,
mm-hmm.
but there are certain ones that you just have to have had a roll call vote.
Yes.
So if you're missing it in the minutes, that would be a problem.
When roll call vote is required,
required.
The minutes shall
so indicate, or something like that. Because that's actually, yeah, that actually works. Yeah, that shall indicate, yeah. For specific reasons, but I mean, it's...
I think you're not going to be able to get rid of them, so when, no matter how you word it, Kathy.
Yeah, because you don't want to say, you don't want to start the sentence with the... But that's like, then you should say the minute shall indicate date, time, and place of meeting. That's not helpful. That doesn't scan. You don't want to start with minutes every time. Any roll call vote.
Yeah,
would that make you happy?
That
any
roll
call
vote.
All right. And then, okay, what else did you have a concern about in that section, Mandy? So it's just any roll call vote. I'm letting you change it, Kathy.
That was my concern.
Okay.
It
said list of documents and other exhibits. It's to just start. No, it doesn't say that. It says list of. It doesn't start with a.
Just list of.
Yeah, because you're trying to scan and take out extraneous words. List of documents and other exhibits used in me. Yep, it just got ahead of you when it was erasing. So that's cool, because that's specifically called out in MGO. We do. Wait, where are we?
Public dialogue.
I didn't touch that.
I don't know whose it is.
I was still in adoption and publication of minutes.
Okay.
It's definitely screwy in terms of the formatting, so that just makes it harder for us to find our place.
I'm okay with an hour. I just saw it as a change.
I don't know. Yes, this is possibly the most boring thing you could do.
So in scanning the rest, the only changes else I had were just Scrivener consistency changes.
Good. And then, so going back to a minute to what is on my document, 3.5 minutes of council meetings. There was the section on content of minutes. There's also a new section B on adoption and publication of minutes.
Does everyone see what just happened? Although
they all changed at once.
They all just changed at once. Why did that happen?
Because it thinks 7 or 6 or 3 is probably too late. You might have to set that. Ignore it for now.
I'm
going to
do a new one.
So while Kathy's fixing that, can everyone else see B, adoption and publication of minutes?
I think during the hour before, because I thought saying 45 minutes was just
What's the version number there, Kathy?
I'm just making it three.
Okay, good.
Okay, can we say this is done?
No, because we still haven't talked about 3B, adoption and publication of minutes. I just want to make sure that when you read it, it now makes sense in light of what we said last time about our deadlines.
I mean, you pretty much copied them all, you know, I think, from being the original BNC.
Yeah, yeah. I just want to make sure that it scans right.
When we say available in an electronic form, what does that mean? To the public on the website?
That's a good question. Is it upon request? On the town's bulletin board, not in an electronic form. We should take out in electronic form and say on the town's bulletin board. And because bulletin board for us is the website.
So the town's bulletin board means the website?
Pretty much.
That's true throughout the charter. That's true throughout the charter. Like the town.
Maybe we should put that in the definitions.
It's defined in the charter.
It's actually defined in the charter, but we could carry it over. Yeah.
The town's bulletin board is defined as the website?
Yes. Because
the town bulletin board, the phrase town bulletin board, so we made it broad because of we use it for posting requirements under open meeting law. The definition complies with open meeting law.
And it's also the town manager's.
So shall mean the display in the town hall on which the town clerk posts no official notices of meetings and upon which other official town notices are posted. The display on the town's website established and maintained by the town as its online repository of municipal information or the display at any other location as may be designated.
Okay, so when it's in use for other things, like meeting postings, there's a backup plan, which is bulletin board. When it's things like the town manager's confirmation of appointments, the backup plan is a physical bulletin board because the website can go down. In a circumstance like this, if this isn't a legal requirement, this is a rule. We could arguably say there's no backup because we're not expecting, in a case of the website going down, somebody to put up draft votes on the physical bulletin board the same way we would if there was a meeting notice that had to be put up bulletin board. The point of doing it this way was showing that it was also to comply with the idea that if your website goes down, you can't just say, oh well, you have to have an actual bulletin board. No, it should be, I think they should be the same.
But I guess the question Kathy had with minutes was, is that one available to the counselors or available to everyone?
If draft minutes exist, they're available to the public. So.
No, I know, but I mean, her point was, for the purpose of the council rules, there's the 4-day requirement to get them to us.
Yeah.
Right, that's what you wanted, I thought. Would be true.
Would be what we want then, versus to the constitution.
And we can, you know, get pushback later on how really we talked about that, on whether or not this is realistic, and staff can tell us that. But these are our aspirations. But I just laid it out. That's like you said.
Except
stuff ends up in SharePoint before it ends up on the on the town website, there's a disconnect there.
There's a little delay.
And so I guess the question, given all this, if what we're saying is bulletin board, which my version doesn't yet say, but if it says bulletin, maybe because you're working now from a saved version.
It's a town website.
Okay, well, my version doesn't say that. Are we on a, are, is...
Yeah, well, you, if you're in the document that I just saved it with me, I just saved it.
Well, I haven't reopened V3. I'm
okay,
still in V2.
So,
but my question is, as we talked about last time, 4 days is obviously well in excess of what is required by open meeting law. But are we still comfortable with 4 days? Do we want to push for that, or do we want to compromise now, or are we good with pushing? I'm fine with whatever we choose. So then my question, I guess, to Darcy is, given your, the concerns that you've expressed associated with this, are, it's a Kathy's original question again, is that to town councilors or is that to the public? And is there a reason that town councilors would see it but the public wouldn't in terms of draft minutes? Because what we do now, right, is we don't give the public our draft minutes until they're like really, really close, right? When they show up in the packet is when everybody's individually been able to write to Margaret and say,
no, that's
not what happened.
No, no, Elizabeth, we are not getting the minutes before they go in the packet,
That's what I'm sorry if I misspoke. I did never intended to say that.
Oh, okay.
We are not, I said the public's not seeing them until they're almost done. If what you're trying to do, because that's when we're seeing them, we're all seeing them at the same time now,
yes.
Rough, well, no, that's not true. They're getting sent to us well beyond this 4 day time frame.
Right. So the question
then they are not being provided to the public. Well, I am too. I want to know, does Darcy want people to have the minutes in the public at the same time that the council gets them, or is she willing for there to be a gap between those two things like there is now? There is in fact currently a gap because Margaret sends them out to us and she doesn't actually get them on the group town council packet until she's gotten all the feedback. And the way it says it does that, right?
Yes. Yes.
Good.
Yes.
Okay, so council committee still needs a substantial amount of work. What was the other one you wanted us to work on today? Kathy, I know what
the
we have in
the process needs is a lot of changes.
Okay. Well, council committees, it seems like, is something that the other thing we need to do, and we do have our list of topics, which I'm referring back to if I can open one of the correct thousands of tabs that I have open. Because we are obviously in compliance with open meeting law. But the other thing we need to have people have a chance to do, because you'd ask to have a chance to do it, is to glance at the information that is in draft form right now, but pretty close and will be influenced by what we decide on council committees associated with liaisons. And that information is in the folder that is reports to town council, right? So there's two documents in there. There's a spreadsheet, there's a report on letterhead. And so why don't we look at that quickly, because then we, in order to finalize that, we need to have the conversation about committees.
Okay, so I'm going to something called reports.
It it's the reports to town council folder, and then it has the report, it has a folder for the 22nd. Council meeting. Why is, honestly, I have no idea if this thing is recording
so
properly now.
That,
if you want to look at that, one is a report on letterhead.
So open the Word one first, or what am I opening?
Sure. Wow, that was assuming that anything would open in any reasonable period of time, which is so not true.
Okay, so this is liaisons, right?
Yep, and it is.
Did you find it?
It's under report to town council by meeting date, by town council meeting date, report to town council 422.
You want me to come around?
And it says report to town council 2019-04-22, rules draft 4-16-19, yesterday at 9:41 p.m. And if you open it in Word, you won't make much difference because this is not really a track changes document. But you'll notice I have highlighted discuss a preferred way. And Kathy, I believe, has a preferred way. So the middle section of this, that okay, so it says, so it has the usual stuff at the top, the way I write reports. It says, as reported to town council 4-1, you can see that in italics, that's just copy and pasted from the last report to town council. Then, where we were talking about liaisons. And then the new information is what's below that. This new information is directly the same as in the committee's section we're gonna look at in a minute. So whatever we change over there, I'll just need to copy and paste over to here. But the other thing that's highlighted is if a whole bunch of people want to be the Board of Health liaison, what's the way to make a final decision? Kathy, drumroll, has an idea for that. And it's in I right now.
This hasn't changed since this morning, right?
I haven't changed it since last night, no. Unless somebody else had something they added.
Okay, so I just have.
It looks funky.
You know, I think the big thing, so we should go to the list. My sense is when the.
So what I'd like
so
to do.
I have just a logistical question.
Mm-hmm.
So on this, I think we were coming to back to the council with the how we think the liaison process should work and why, and then saying, here's a list, and giving that list, and then saying, everyone should look at this list, and at the next meeting, indicate which you want. You know, so we're not having like an hour-long discussion at the first meeting. It's more presentation on why we picked these committees, here's a list. So I'm just looking at, I think you have, during that meeting,
I disagree based on what we wrote last time in that I believed that at the meeting of the 22nd, because they would have had this information in their packet and then had a discussion, they would go ahead and express preferences on the night of the 22nd.
So they've got 4 days to think about.
Yes, is the idea.
Yeah, I don't think it would be reasonably time consuming unless we're all coming with a preference sheet.
So the other problem is that this is not, right, if we go by your method, it is not the president decides. So what traditionally has happened up until now, right, is we've talked about a charge, we've approved a charge, then people have expressed preference to be on a committee, and then in between committees, the president has solicited names and then brought those names back. We are saying we wanted a different process for this. We didn't want the president to solicit the names. The Excel is.
No, but the Excel sheet doesn't identify the priority list.
Yes,
at all.
It does. It has a whole set of priority codes associated with it. It's a spreadsheet.
It's coded?
It has like 12 fields. Yes. Yeah.
So I think it would be helpful to say somewhere in the report, this is the group of committees we as believe the council should have liaisons for, like Kathy did in her draft liaison memo. And here's the ones that had select board voting members and talk about them.
That's why we have this spreadsheet. It has all that information on it.
Implies, when I look at this spreadsheet, without explanation, it implies that we are seeking liaisons for every single committee in this town.
The explanation, I disagree. The explanation is in the text. I'm not going to write out three additional pages of text with lists, or even half an extra page with a list of committees. We're going to work from spreadsheets because that's a sensible way to approach life rather than these constant text lists of things. And we need to be able to show that there are a whole bunch of committees that already have people on them or don't have people on them, and not just say, out of context of all the rest of the committees that you may or may not be aware of, we are picking these 10. We can talk today about which are the ones that belong in category one, or if you don't, or if you want fewer categorizations, like one and everything else. But I am not good with saying we have to have something for the trust and the school committee and CPAC and never mention all the rest of the things.
I think we need to list the committees we're not recommending. Don't get
which
me wrong.
Is why they're on here. And here they are.
I see a priority group in this Excel sheet that doesn't say no to anything.
It has ones, twos, threes, and town councils. So I'm happy to say in the text, I'm happy to either change the priority grouping coding system, or I'm happy to say in the text, look at group one, and but we should make sure that we agree on what group one is, however we do it.
Yes.
I picked this based on things other people said.
Like a one, two, and three. So we basically
only the ones are the group that we were recommending right now.
So
that's what a one means.
My problem with this ranking, okay? I could see a bunch, the ones would be priority groups, and then everything else would be, we didn't think it was necessary or priority, but anyone could have it. Going from one through four doesn't make any sense.
Sorry, I disagree.
It doesn't make sense to me because is it for meaning like you don't see any reason anyone would ever want to be one? But I would just, can't we do one is what we think should be a priority based on a look at what the charges are. And then here's a list of everything else. And then you've also got this list of
all the other work that we're all doing. I thought that your name was the one that was forwarded to the town manager. Then that's my mistake.
So the priority group one,
that's what I got from the spreadsheet that she provided.
Is it actually identical to the priority groups that the last time
we talked?
It's not even identical to that.
The ones don't match
what we talked about.
We talked about in generalities. We did not come up with a specific list. Okay, well, I guess I wasn't here.
That was the list I gave you.
So then I suggest you look at this and see what needs to be changed to priority one, and then we can call everything else doesn't matter. My problem, okay, so I'll say that and let you look at one. But see, here's my problem, Kathy. You're not, I refuse as a town council to say it's really important to have a liaison to the school committee and the library trustees, right? Those are in group one. And maybe five other things are priority group one. And then everything else doesn't matter. So if you want to go off to Kanagasaki Sister City Committee and be a liaison, that's great.
I would just make them twos. I'm not saying
we'll make them recommended.
Right.
I don't know what that category is.
That's why there's a whole thing called possible member. That's called possible member, but it depends on what the bylaws of
the
organization are.
Change the priority group on those so that you can sort by priority group. Because right now the possible members are in multiple different priority groups.
Possible members are all twos.
That should be added to one.
Possible members are all twos.
So let's just
well, that's not true. Yeah, there's a three. Why would the Agricultural Commission be bringing us the equivalent of something the trust or the school committee or the library trustees or the zoning subcommittee of the planning board is bringing us?
We didn't talk about that list. We recognize you weren't here when we came
right.
up with that initial list, and we never did have that extra conversation.
Right.
Is this the right list? But I think we need to talk about that list.
Right, which is why, yeah.
But I noticed that our initial list did not agree with what you came up with, so we should have that conversation. I don't see CDBG on here.
Yes, it is.
Is it? Oh, there it is. Sorry, it's really tiny. Now I see it. I think we need to talk about the list.
So we can talk, we should definitely talk about the list. So of the ones that are in priority group.
Yeah, that's number four.
You can resort it by name. You don't have to sort it by priority group. We have, that's why it's a spreadsheet, not just a list of text. I took it, I moved it down.
Which of the two brings a...
And CDBG was on the list.
Which of the two cultural council brings a public art?
That's why cultural council isn't a one. But public art's also not a one. It's a two, I think, right now. But if, so... How I defined my numbers was based on my experiences of what these committees do and how likely they were to bring things to town meeting. Back when we had town meeting. So that was what
so,
I based it
you
on.
Think the twos are somewhat likely?
Yes. And that's why I made more, that's why I decided to go instead of just one and everything else, I kind of tiered it that way and tried to keep things that were roughly equivalent like AgCom and ConCom in the same category. But if you are certain, so here's my point. So we're looking at the first seven of these, right? Going from the trust to the Transportation Advisory Committee. That's already seven assignments.
Mm-hmm.
How many assignments are you guys looking to make?
We don't know. That's what the council has to discuss.
Right, but you want to make a reasonable recommendation to them.
We initially had 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 on the list, not so, including downtown.
So here's a thought on this. I think there's a difference between the downtown parking working group, which is that it's called a possible member, the way you've done these possible members.
To add home.
Pardon? And I make it to choose these possible member ones where there used to be a select board member on it, or we decided there should not be a council.
It's not about us deciding, it's about the bylaws of the organization. The Amherst Media bylaws have not yet been rewritten to determine if it belongs to be a staff member or a select board member. Those are bylaws, those aren't just up to the town council to decide.
Then that's even more so. I would cluster the things that we don't even know whether we're going to be a member.
That's why I wrote possible member.
No, but I take them out of the laundry list and make them their own group because it's very different. If we cannot now choose them, then it does not need to be a choice on Monday night, right? So I would just make them their own group. I don't care whether you call it spreadsheet 2 or list 2.
I want one spreadsheet because I want people to be able to see, oh, Amherst Media Board Directors is on this page, but it's over here. Let's code it something else. Code it something else. Well, I've called it possible member. Code it priority group X. Code it priority group M or 4 or something.
So
but I don't want a separate list.
It needs coded separately. Then
that's why I've used possible member. So liaison or possible member is already written there, so instead of having a priority group, it's just an X instead.
Yeah, exactly.
Because we don't know.
Exactly. We don't have a choice right now. And so down part of the parking group, I do the same way because I'm not sure we can liaison with it as opposed to be a member.
But we could liaison to it now while it's still working. That's why that and the trust have that funky and as well as working group is until we find out someone might very well really want to go to downtown parking working group whether or not we figure out right well even though in theory we intended TAC to absorb them and then we'd have a liaison to TAC.
So
I'm uneasy making everything that's there an X. If I had a choice, I'd send someone. I'd consider it a one. Of all the things that I was trying to reflect what was previously stated, but. Right. And we have, the old executive body used to avoid sending people to elected bodies. We specifically called out library trustees and school committee as something we should have a liaison to, so arguably the Rita DeVara Mellon Authority is not substantially different.
The charter allows them needed to call it out if we wanted the option because they're excluded as multiple member bodies.
Right.
So we can call out to allow the option.
Okay, so I just changed it to one.
Good. I won't argue with you on any of these. I just wanted, when we sorted it, I will actually, but when we sorted it by numbers, I wanted to see how many there were. And so now we're up to 8.
Like
to it. Maybe a 3 is the height in line.
I kind of like instead of groups, unless your memo will indicate what those groupings mean out of rules. Because I guess I'm thinking a random counselor who hasn't been part of this discussion reading this spreadsheet will look at it and think, are they recommending everyone? So either in the report, say the rules committee is recommending appointing liaisons to priority groups 1 and 2 or 1 or whatever,
that,
is not recommending
yes.
that. Something like that that
right.
explains
the others,
that.
The others are just at the option of counselors, but you know, they're not.
Well, they're not liaisons then, if it's at the option of counselors.
No, I meant that a counselor could choose to be a liaison to something else that we didn't put on the list of their work.
Not if the ones and twos. Right, that's my whole point. That's what I was saying about Kanagasaki earlier. You don't pick something that's a 4 when we haven't filled up all the ones or ones and twos.
So all these possible members, do they turn into an X? So
no, they don't, actually. That's the problem. So I might need to make them a 4 or something because, I mean, Downtown Parking Working Group, somebody might very well reasonably want to go to now since they're
going to
bring us something.
I'm going to the other ones.
The trust, we don't know what the rule is yet.
PBTA,
the one you just said, that is the bylaws of the entity that would determine whether or not.
And we may need a legal definition. And so the trust, we don't know. But in the meantime, okay, so at Amherst Media's board, they're not required to have public meetings. Mm-hmm. Therefore, it's only listed as possible member, not as something we would send a liaison to. The Affordable Housing Trust, enough people have said they're interested in their work and they might be bringing us something that even if we can't figure out yet, if we're allowed to have a seat, probably somebody should go. And that's why it says liaison and possible member.
No, I think that's a good one. I'm just trying to see if there's another one.
So that's what those
like
categories mean. They don't bring us anything. They don't bring us anything.
They seem like they should.
They don't bring us anything.
But
maybe you want them to bring us more stuff.
I mean, our initial policy was people bringing us stuff. But I think, and I don't know how strict Ag and ConCom are in terms of local bylaws versus everything they do is regulated by state. Is there stuff they do that is regulated by local bylaws? If so, having a liaison, even though they don't necessarily bring us actions, could be helpful as we're reviewing bylaws to determine
right.
policies.
Yeah, right.
But if everything they do is regulated by state law and nothing
mm-hmm.
is controlled locally, then I get, and I don't
right.
know enough about that.
So cultural council's definitely in the category of they do what they're told to
right.
do by the state. So I could certainly see, I mean, I think we have, I can, you know, we could actually talk about this for hours. So I guess what I'm trying to get a sense of is, and yes, I'm sorry I didn't write that sentence with a yellow highlight on it because that was my intention once I figured out what the coding was, is if we're gonna say, I think it's fair to consider ones and twos, whichever thing we make ones and twos, and saying, definitely this top group, ideally also this group, depending on how many bodies we can get to go to these things, because we're gonna end up with a couple of liaison assignments each, depending on how far we get down this list. And then whichever things we change to ones and twos, but those are the because I think there is a natural break point between the ones and the twos, and then it starts getting muddier. You know, is it really a 3 or a 4 or a 5.6? So can we move, let's move some things around and then I would say ones and twos. And the reason I have twos next to possible members for Pioneer Valley is because we need to figure it out sooner rather than later. And so that's one of the things too.
Which of the two communities
So Board of Health is different because, one, it's true that they will never bring us anything, and at the same time, they will do things that we know nothing about because they're not required to include us in anything they do. So if we're concerned about things that turn out to be under the Board of Health's purview, we're never going to hear about them because they literally don't have to bring us anything. Whereas CONCOM or AGCOM might decide they want to change a bylaw, in which case they would bring us stuff, but it hasn't happened in a long time. But that's different than, so, I mean, there's a judgment call in here.
I have two others, disability access and human rights.
So, human rights, we can move, both of those we can move down. The reason I wanted to call attention to them here was to catch your eye. And that was because human rights is definitely going to have to change the human rights bylaw, but, you know, whatever, it'll go to GOL at some point and they'll have to change it. And people have expressed interest in what human rights is doing because that's an interesting thing for people to want to go to, as I look around the room at where people usually sit. And then the other part of it is DAAC has been very siloed, and they have a lot of strong opinions about things that should be influencing, I would argue, us at JCPC and finance, and as well as putting resources into ensuring that we have plans up to date on a lot of things. So I feel like that's a personal one on my part. I feel like it's been sort of left to the side and it needs more attention because they're working hard to do a lot of things, but it's not well integrated into what we're able to establish as priorities. It's depending entirely on staff getting it someplace. So I think it's an area in need of attention. Personnel board's on there because, you know, people want to know about the, how we're applying minimum wage, and you know, like, right, they might bring us a change. There's a responsible employer bylaw they have to fix. But again, I mean, things have to be fixed. They have to go through a process anyway, whether or not we're particularly beholden to sending them there.
Are your twos with you guys, the select board liaisons, to all your twos?
Not necessarily. For example, we never sent people to a because we're executive branch, we never sent people to other executive branches because we thought that was rude. And so we didn't do it. And so that's just different.
To move this along, keep the ones, keep the twos. Everything else becomes a three.
Okay.
Although maybe we move ag and com up to two.
Move ag and com up to two. Got it.
Everything else becomes a three. We say threes are the ones we're not recommending.
At this time.
At this time, yeah. And we have to recognize this will be a discussion on Monday night. I would put in the memo not that people have to express their interest on Monday night, because I think we have to settle which ones before people can express interest, and then people need to think about priorities and all on their own once they know the final list.
Right, because they don't know the entire landscape. If they have their heart set on something that we actually all demote to a three, then they need to pick something else.
To know where we start pulling.
So I'll make the fours into threes.
And then
I made CONCOM. Nothing ever disappears. We tried to get rid of the parking group before. It's still not done. The Amherst Center Recreation Working Group is supposed to be done. It's still not done. Will the dark park be done? Maybe.
And DPW fire station,
isn't that? No, it's gone right now. It's going to be reconvened.
Right.
But I think
it might be reconvened.
And if it's reconvened as anything, I'm pretty sure somebody from this body is going to want to be associated with it, whether as, if it's not as a member, then certainly as a liaison.
So that's my first recommendation. I noticed other than on for the town council positions, you put the members. But then you had George and yourself listed on these other two. I find it strange that
I don't know why it happened, but it did.
I would delete those two and leave what already has been appointed. So if ECAC hasn't been appointed formally, we should have
I took that off.
And then I'm just curious, you put the CCC statewide one and these two MMA one you're on, and then just the whole MMC, the whole thing.
Right.
I would delete them as
So the reason for this, so the reason for this is we did do that exact thing on the back of every single select board agenda. We listed all the possible committees that we might be reporting out about so that we did not feel like we had to, we felt that helped us comply with open meeting law by saying under member reports, we might be speaking of any of these committees, and it had those committees and our liaison name listed on the back of every single agenda. So it was a way of showing the public who was connected to which committee. I'm not suggesting that we republish this every time we republish a town council agenda, but I do feel there should be one document that includes everything, and that's why it's a spreadsheet. Yes, because those are all things we may speak of and that we may need to send designees to at some point, or we may say, you know, you've been going to those legislative breakfasts. We think some, you know, if somebody says, I'm going to give that up so I can go to so-and-so's meetings on Friday mornings, et cetera. I think this should be covering the scope of all the things we do, because there is no document that covers the scope of all the things we do. But I'm happy, that's why I just haven't coded town council right now.
I think it misleads that it's coded town council for those statewide ones.
Well, okay.
And like participatory budgeting and right choice voting could just be charter, could be listed as charter.
But they are town, but they're town council members.
Yes.
On them, on one of them and not on
yes.
the other one.
Not
one's a liaison and one's a member.
Well, the whole thing, I mean, you're not really a council volunteer when you're appointed to a committee.
Right.
But I'm okay.
I'm talking about workload. The reason it's a workload issue. It's a workload issue. I mean,
I know. And so I'm okay with leaving it. I'm wondering if we get another column that says town or council, so and then puts others as regional, state, so that they know where this committee comes from, instead of just the appointing authority. You put town ad hoc, town. What would conform to
so
the
I
charge?
Have so would you change? So you're saying,
well, under her column D, Mandy, it's member three, number two. It could be council committee, you know, regional. You see how it's going down? It's, you know, regional meeting or something. We don't really need member three, number two. So it could just be.
We do. We need to know how many people are on these things. We have no list that we can regularly refer to.
You've done a list of five people. I'm just saying that.
And when one of them leaves.
Maybe, I understand that member three means it's a council committee with three people on it. So I don't really care. I'm just
potentially add extra columns so that the column on liaison or possible member doesn't include how many, and there's a separate column that says number of counselors
okay.
to liaise or be members.
Right. So if I, but okay, I understand. I think.
Just extra columns to help clear stuff up.
So, oh God, I have to open it.
And so the most important thing we need out of this right now, the Monday, right?
Is do we agree on the ones and twos?
It is the ones and twos, because it's hopefully people will start looking
way and we upped CONCOM and we upped AGCOM and. We left the rest. I'm going to change the fours to threes.
21
right.
is a really long list.
Yeah.
It's a really long list, right? So that's our ones and our twos.
Yes, 21.
That's more than enough.
That's sufficient work for people.
Even numbered divisible by
I think people will add enough in and then we'll get to 26.
Yeah, that one's, you know, and so that 22 is slightly high because some of them are members that we may not get members of.
Right.
PBTA, PBDC, Amherst Media.
We're not clear if we'll get those or not, but we want them to be addressed as at a level two, because if it turns out we just can't serve on Pioneer Valley Planning Commission,
so
then we need to know that.
On number 19, George is already the UMass campus group, and you're already UTAC?
Yep, just because UTAC's not meeting, and so I put my name there until UTAC is reconstituted or killed off permanently.
So George
is appointed a member before you get on council.
I have no idea why George is going, but that's what I was told by Andy when I put him down for something else on some other conversation, and he's like, George is going. I'm like, okay, that's cool. When that happened?
So
the volunteer issue, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm looking at, is F, I want to do it, or is it, I am on it already?
Yeah.
So right now it's, I am on it already, and then the spaces are for, you know, for people to, like,
so
if I print it as a spreadsheet, they could use it as their own worksheet, or they obviously they could use it electronically.
I would make an F. I'd open up.
Well, but these are the vacancies. All the blank spaces are vacancies. So four people might volunteer to be the liaison to the Affordable Housing Trust, or five people or one person, and then their names can, as a temporary, their names can be filled in.
Already appointed members and just highlight the cells, and then somewhere you can describe the highlight being, you know, pink cells represent members already, counselors already appointed to these groups.
Right, because these are only counselor members that are, I mean, these are only council town counselors who are listed here.
Are we assuming that each committee only gets one liaison?
Yes. And the reason there are multiple spaces here is while people are trying to sort out who wants what. Just like Lynn did when she sent us the chart that's like, these were your ones, and these were your twos, and these were your threes. Because it may be that some only get one volunteer, and some get three volunteers, and then we have to potentially draw straws.
I'm okay with the drawing straws.
Sounds perfectly good.
Sounds.
Or is it names in hat when the Board of Registrars does, or is it sticks? Do they have like set sticks, or what do they call it?
I thought it was names in a hat, but it's been a really long time, and I really can't remember.
Because if they
sure.
have like the set of sticks or straws or whatever, or lot or whatever they do, we can just use whatever the board does when they determine.
Yeah,
okay, so I will add a column, and I will highlight, and I will add some text. So this brings us back to then, if we go into the actual council committee's document, Kathy, and we look at the liaison section in there to make sure we're happy with what it says, because whatever it says is what I need to put in the report. Would appreciate us being there. I'm sorry.
No. I'm thinking that Kathy Mitchell is cool with it, I would say.
That one, and I'm still concerned about redevelopment, are two of the ones I would be concerned about. I'm also concerned about school committee and library trustees, even though it went into the charter, simply because they're fellow elected officials.
Exactly.
Although housing is.
So US
I did change redevelopment to one.
Was
elected and is now appointed.
I just don't really have a clue as to whether it makes sense to put it up there. Affordable Housing Trust is already up there.
Well, the Housing Trust, in theory, will have a counselor as a trustee, so it's
right.
Unless, you know, not
potentially. Yeah.
It always has.
The Housing Authority basically is just in control of the building.
Yes.
Right?
It does. It does submit requests for funding.
CPAC money.
Yep, and CDBG money.
CDBG, right.
Yep.
I
So, but that's why I left it a 3, because it's not like how it doesn't matter to us. It's just that in terms of, you know, spending our time, where can we be most effective at helping? Helping or being helped, and I didn't see us as necessarily being able to help them or being helped by them.
Okay, I would, as we go to the memo, here's another suggestion. I need your guys to finalize this, since we're kind of not going to get to anything else. If we remind people that we have that long memo that you guys did for us, it was really helpful for me yesterday to go look at what these things do. You know, so we.
It doesn't say that in the report right now. So Kathy's liaison thing, I'm not using that anymore. That was background information. So I'm sorry, what are we talking about?
So your report has a draft rule 10.8.
Yes.
And then the council committees has a draft rule 10.8, all for liaisons.
That they track now because in the version that I saved, because I didn't want to mess up the other one. And so the version I saved, it tracks. Yeah, there's, I tried to do what I thought I was told to do in terms of saving things, and so
I looked at it before you put yours on last night.
Yeah, I understand. We're not supposed to express an opinion before meeting. So the, it should be under meetings. It should be under council committees, right?
It would be council committees.
So we had a full 10.8.
There was one in the document I saved, which was V2.
So I took Kathy's V2 4.11 CS track.
That's the one I thought.
And then I changed the section about liaisons, which is how you have the liaison section you have now in the draft report.
Okay.
And so as we continue to change it, so perhaps since I didn't change all these other things that were in Kathy's version, instead of bringing up V2411 CS track, bring up V2411 CS track ABB 41519. Because that's what changed.
So did you change anything other than 10.8 in your version?
No. It looks like 1.8 on my version if I don't open it in Word. But no, that's the only section that I worked on. Right, because I had to, I'm trying to take, you know, make sure that our report says the same thing that our current version of the rule says. So it's the only section here. Yes. Okay. So all your notes are in a saved version of a different saved version of Kathy's. Right, but not Kathy's, right? It's a separate thing, yes. Okay. Right. Yes. It's only 10.8 that changed.
Okay.
But 10.8 did change substantially.
Yes, it changed substantially.
So for only 10.8, look at my version. For everything else, look at the one you wrote all your notes on. So we should look at section 10.8 in my version because it has a few more words than what it says in the draft because it has a preceding paragraph. The A through J are the same, mm-hmm. but the preceding paragraph is additional. Right, the A through J in the ELISA version. Good question. Somebody will end up with five and somebody will end up with one.
Well, I see an issue with that. Because you would then have to decide which ones do you draw straws first.
Right.
If you're lucky, a bunch of them just kind of turn out. But then there's certainly going to be some people are going to want to feel really strongly. And I think that could be part of the discussion this coming Monday, and then people could go home and think about it more. They will, they'll be jealous. It's Jay. They will. They get jealous when they see a good.
I would delete that sentence. I would just say, we name our liaisons, and if you're going to do it, you've got to deal with it.
I think that's mean. I think there's no reason why they can't ask, and that's why we say subject to availability. Just, we're sorry. But it might be that some committee really wants us there, or maybe what they really want is us to just come to one meeting, right? And so let them ask.
Okay.
Let them ask. They can fire. Bodies who are like, get this person out of my room. Yeah. So that fits in. Between H and I and J is where it was to put something that's you like have to pick your top two or something. You know what I mean? Like, so what do we?
So I mean, we've got the indicate. We can figure it out on Monday. We've got
right.
The indicate, and then as we're figuring that out, since it's going to have to be a meeting,
then we can if we decide to come up with this will work this time. That'll be fine, and indicate is enough in the rule. If we come up with some cool procedure, we can add it to the rules.
Well, I think H and J make it clear without saying that there's only going to be one counselor as a liaison, because it says if there's more than one wanting it, then we draw straws. You know, so what we're saying, you know, so you should pick as many committees as you really want, because you may, you know, if you only want two, you should only pick two, right?
Right. It may say.
Chances are we can do
this. Depending on who the other people were, I'd be perfectly fine for that.
horse trading usually worked when there were five of us. It's just more complicated when there are 13. You know,
yeah,
everything's just a little harder.
Yeah, so I have no idea. You know, some people are naturally going to want to be linked to something, and others are going to have two or three things they want to keep following.
I think for now, this the straws is we're not going to know until we truly figure it out.
Yeah. So we'll have that be, this is our draft rule. This is our draft.
And let's see.
It's okay, but that's our draft. And so, if you're good with that, don't forget that there's the preceding text paragraph there.
So D, I would just say liaisons may not participate remotely, period. Get rid of the extraneous as they're not voting numbers. Just say they may not participate remotely.
Why?
D.
Why take it off?
Because I think it's extraneous.
So we don't want them to participate
remotely.
Period.
I don't care whether they could buy the remote participation policy or not.
They can't because we didn't address that in the policy, but the policy says members.
Theory,
a liaison's not a member.
A liaison's not a member, but in theory you could have someone randomly call someone up because they're not a member and have them on the phone just because. You know, we can't prevent a random person in the audience from having their phone on speaker and someone else there, right? And so why not just say, no,
I think it's
you're not participating unless you're in the room.
I think we're in total agreement on the fact that they can't. I think I'm just less concerned with cutting off the end of the sentence, but if that's what makes y'all happy, go for it. So aside from the section on... You can't, no, you absolutely have to say that. I guarantee somebody's going to try and do it if you don't say it. I guarantee that. So we're still on the AVB version because we're trying to make sure we have this right, because I need to transfer this version directly to the report that I have to get into people's hands tomorrow. So... I'm gonna unhighlight the straws because we're good with that. I mean, we're good with I, and so that's fine now.
One of the things you deleted from the original draft that I was staring at was liaison shall bring back to the council and write any policy recommendations. Is that what E is supposed to be? Liaison shall report any of the other
yes.
bodies pending policy or budget. Okay, so it's not gone.
It's
okay.
Definitely softened, but it's not gone. So think about how hard that is, because I'm thinking of.
On my initial scan.
Yeah. It's buried in there.
So I thought it was missing.
That's in the report, yes. Yes, absolutely. So I'm just taking off the end of that sentence where it says, as they are not voting members. Yeah, that's why I'd leave it at the end. I'll put a line above it so that people don't have to read it if they don't want to. I'm just not willing to not carry forward the history. We have too much random stuff that doesn't have dates on it, and I want to show where we're at. I mean, people don't have to read when our meetings were if they don't want to, but I shouldn't be prevented from tracking that within the report if I choose to. But I can try and, you know, maybe I'll put it as a footnote. How's that?
No, I think you'd be fine just putting the book. You know, like you can stop.
Yes.
You can stop reading.
Only for real geeks section. Oh, by the way, in terms of our formatting, are we supposed to have periods at the end of each of these phrases?
I would say yes.
Okay, good.
Yes.
I was trying to do that, but I wasn't sure. So liaisons may not participate remotely. Because you're doing so many formatting things. Periods are what we're typically using. And then, which brings me to the question of when there's a charter reference or an MGL reference, is that inside the period or outside the period?
So outside the period, but in parentheses.
Good. Got it.
I think is the one I'm going to suggest to Kathy.
Yes. It should hang by itself, right? The sentence should end, and then the reference should be there. Yes, got it. Good, okay. So that was all. So you should get rid of, right. So the only changes I made were I took away the end of liaisons may not participate remotely because they're not voting members. Took out that part. I took off the highlight about the drawing straws. And that section is remaining, and that is what I'm going to transfer to our report as our draft rule. Now, in terms of all the other stuff about council committees that we're going to whiz through in the 15 minutes before Kathy has to go, we should be looking at Kathy's CS track plus whatever notes you made yourself on your own copies, because that's the only thing I changed on my version was the part about liaisons.
Just one other on this thing, see separate document recommended.
You're back on my report.
No, you have a see recommended action for town council 4/22/19 and 11/26/18.
So that's a marker to myself to reference that select board memo. That's what we just talked about. That's the marker to myself. I just added that while we were talking. That's how I noted to myself, I have to fix that. I have to fix that. That's my Alyssa fix thing.
Okay, you'll fix it.
Yes.
Okay.
I just added it, and I will fix it.
So we're on council committees. Where did we get to last week? What happened before this? We got 3 hours and 2 days.
Okay,
we have 15 minutes. So what do you want to focus on today, Kathy?
So am I looking at the Alyssa
No.
Yours.
Look at yours. Yeah, the V2411, right? Yeah.
I'm curious about 10.9. I've got other things, but 10.9, council appointment to other multiple member entities.
I know, if you don't open it in Word, it's calling it 1.9, but you know, whatever. We know where it is. We know what it is. It's the one near the end that's in yellow.
What's the goal?
I stuck that in because of this issue of all these other things. We should just take it out.
I can just take it out.
I just stuck it in. I'm thinking if we had to be thorough, we have somewhere in the middle of this year, the end of this year,
We'll figure it out
and then
later.
Just add it to how they get on.
But we can modify it.
That's the only reason.
I would just take it out completely at this point. And if we decide we want down listed in the rules,
yes, so that's the only
we'll add that in.
Jen, can you keep a record that if I'm afraid if I do it on this it's not going to be 10.9. Thank you. you know, then mentally with you.
Mentally when you're volunteering.
But these would be in the council where it is, like, Linda's not going to appoint you. She's.
She won't make a recommendation.
So she would report back, here's the sheet.
Yeah. And I'm okay with that. I would just change the word entities to committees. And I actually changed the title. Recommended change to the title. I want council appointments to committees named in the charter. If those are, since we're talking about the law of charters established on Allen. 10-7 is what you were referencing. I was wrong. Darcy. 10-7 is the things like ECAC, ECAC.
So Mandy, by doing that, I'm fine with doing that. The earlier comment you made, once we get these other committees, this process would work for the others. So we would just have to come back and, because now we said it's just these.
Right. Well, it kind of referenced those anyway. Just those anyway.
Yeah, no, we did just, because that's what
we had. No, we'll have to, if we get appointments to other committees,
and
we'll have to
found this
figure it out.
I found this in, I forget, I had originally studied, another town had a situation where we had, where they were fairly putting counselors on something, and they had this, a separate process from the president appointing, they had this.
Right, and so.
There was only one Randall.
Should it, because there are other committees that would fall into this category, should it be
that's right.
Other than committees of the town council?
So what we're not
like
sure
that?
Of is, because if you look at 10-7, what happened with ECA?
I'm gonna call, can I make it town-like things?
Oh,
that's the issue.
10-7?
No, just council appointments to ICE.
I would keep 10-6 named in the charter because it's only referencing those two. This point. What I was going to say with 10-7 is 10-7 is things like the ECAC. Oh, what I was going to say with the other ones, like Affordable Housing Trust and all of these, we don't know if they change their, well, they're not a town committee, but if some other town committee, what's one that had a voting member? Downtown Parking Working Group had a voting member.
From the executive branch.
If they change their charge to say voting member of the town council, it acts the same way as ECAC acts, which means the manager is going to make that appointment.
Okay, so right. I'm going to leave this right now, so I'm going to have to go to the attorney. But I know we got a legal opinion on that. I didn't agree with the opinion, and I never went out and found another lawyer to ask them. I think there's a separation of powers issue with a hired manager with an elected official. So I realize that we're silent on that. And clearly the charter makes the distinction between if we didn't name it, the town manager does it. But I can't imagine a legislature sweeping.
Here's the history. The Charter Commission never imagined before
that there would be
non-council committees that have councilors on them because of the separation of powers. If it's an executive committee, it doesn't have councilors on it. It has liaisons. That's why we have provided for liaisons. So the charter did not provide for this possibility, which is why the charter ends up with a very odd reading.
So I completely understood that that was the assumption. And then when we hit the first reality, we hit this, would you agree? Is that a technical amendment to the charter?
It would be an amendment to the charter. I think the commissioners, if it had been believed
that this could happen,
would have made the president, not the whole council, the president the appointer of councilors to any committee a councilor serves on. It would not have made the council the appointers.
Even though you have the town council as the appointing authority in the wording of the charter.
Yeah, I don't think it would have done that. There's some oddities. I think the intent of the commissioners was that the president appoints councilors to committees. The manager appoints non-councilors to all committees other than these residents. and maybe I'm just reading it wrong. This sentence of the town manager asked the council to recommend councilors and follow the process established by OCA to identify, interview, and recommend council and resident members of the multiple member body. The manager has his own process for recommending, especially residents, to any committee. We can't tell him he has to follow the OCA process for his recommendations. Maybe I'm reading this wrong, but at a minimum, I would get rid of and resident members. But,
so we've had several discussions, we just haven't finalized it.
I don't even remember writing those words.
Drafting those words.
So I have to ask something as Kathy's leaving, because we're going to note that she's leaving, but I need to know that one of the things we had on the posting, very specifically, was the Finance Committee recommendation to make sure that nobody had changed or had additional thoughts based on the conversations we've had since then. So, because Council is supposed to discuss that on the 22nd, what rules recommended, what OCA recommended at the April 1 Finance Committee, but I included it in today's list of topics in case anybody wanted to revisit it.
Well, no, Finance basically, Finance.
Is anyone still signed in? Or is this Alyssa updated? There's two people over there, so I don't know.
Okay, maybe Alyssa's still signed in.
I'm probably still signed in.
It's probably Alyssa.
I think Finance assuming.
No, it is Kathy too. Mail, SCH.
So what do I have to do?
I don't know.
He got me in.
I guess when you go out of Wi-Fi zone, it'll just kick off.
One assumes, right? It'll disconnect somehow.
Finance is assuming that OCA takes over, that decision, the Finance doing the interviews was in effect turned down during the meeting, and we will be doing some draft interview questions that we think should be asked.
It was not discussed at the last meeting. It's on the upcoming agenda to make that decision as a full council.
It was discussed some, but yeah. Council-wide policy on what?
On Finance Committee resident appointments.
Right, because we're supposed to have a rule.
Because it's supposed to be in rules.
Right.
Okay.
So basically, we didn't come back and discuss it again because of the discussion that we just talked about how many interview questions.
Yeah. So I still support the original rules recommendation that stays with Finance.
Okay. I was not trying to relitigate. I was merely giving people the opportunity if something had come up in conversations you had so that we could talk about it, because we shouldn't have talked about it if it wasn't on. Things on the list of topics don't have to be discussed, but we would not have been allowed to discuss it if something had come up, because it would have been anticipated. I'm talking about open meeting law. I'm just saying I was giving us the option. Doesn't mean anything has come up.
That was my report.
Cool. So you're working on finance related questions, just as
we're just doing, like, these are the questions we want. Whether we're doing the interview, someone else is doing the interview, someone has to ask these questions of whoever the applicants are. And here's a paragraph on what kind of qualifications or experience or knowledge they might bring.
Cool, because I know Sarah was having that conversation with Andy, just as she had it with Mark Parent and with Greg Stutzman about planning board and zoning board of appeals. So if you have a more formal assignment, all to the good.
This will be a unique situation of not having somebody in the room doing the interviews.
Do we know that Sarah is aware of the difference between the
Sarah is aware of what being brought up on Monday.
The vote of the council on Friday.
Yes, everyone knows that we made our reports, we both made our rules, and OCA both made our reports on the 1st, and that it's supposed to be on the agenda for the 22nd to make the decision.
Oh, how did everyone know that?
Because we were at the meeting on the 1st. I recommend, I also had a motion to recommend that having taken both those reports into account that we, or that rules was, I had the motion that rules was, as I believed we talked about in a previous meeting, moving it along to OCA. OCA then had a report hot off the press, right, because we did it that day for that meeting that night. And so now you council have heard both their viewpoints, go home and think about it and come back on the 22nd and decide. Well, that's the problem with.
No long explanations, no extra words. We need to get those two sections plus Shalini's values done enough to bring into a full document so everyone can read it from the beginning to the end.
Right. I think that the values document actually, I think, needs a fair amount of work because the initial statements are in one format.
So listen, my suggestion
so,
might be, I really have to go, but okay, my suggestion might be, should we try to book a 3-hour meeting? If we can only do it during a meeting, we might need a 3-hour meeting or we might need an extra meeting.
So
one way or the other.
Based on this week's list of topics, we had town council committees, legislative process, liaison and ex officio meetings and values. And we still have to do all of those except for liaison and ex officio.
5 minutes on details of minutes. So we just need to be as efficient as possible as we can because, you know, on the next ones through. And if we can't, we're just going to have to end meetings.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye.
So. That's just thrown in there
that's
awkwardly. That needs to be dealt with slightly differently, but it's.
I think it's fine in a sense. It needs formatted.
But once we see how the rest of the format works, it can fit better. But it doesn't need to be so awkwardly worded either. By majority vote, like why does that even say that? Like.
Or just we could just say that council shall appoint.
We could just quote the charter there.
Yeah, which I think is just the council shall appoint.
Yep. We don't need the by majority vote thing because that doesn't scan with all the rest of them. It doesn't have equivalencies in the other sections.
Who shall serve as staggered 3-year terms and vote by vote of the council? It's basic. This creation of, it's titled New Town Committees. I would just say creation of town committees. New is kind of redundant.
That was actually a question I had, is we should somewhere define that the appointments committee, which is currently OCA, what its role is somewhere in here, because like it's mentioned just once or twice, and then, but it, in reference to something else, it's not clearly laid out that they have a responsibility here, at least in one of the versions I was reading.
It's,
and so.
Oh, yeah, because we are attaching the charges to the
right.
Appendix.
And so, but it is literally part of the process, and so.
My legislative process has automatic referral appointments to OCA.
Okay, so that's good. But somehow in here we need to, yeah, someplace we just need to tie them together so people know to go to the other place.
So, I mean, this is the town, this is, so this is the ones when we create a committee like ECAP, we can, we're going to just say in our rules, we can do that. It has both. In this event, it reads the town manager shall ask the town council to recommend counselors and follow the process, and then it was that follow that process for all of that. Instead of doing that and sort of telling the town manager what he has to do, could we word it, the town council shall refer to the town manager counselors who are interested in being appointed within days of creating the committee?
I think we need to have Kat. She's, I have had nothing to do with this section.
Right.
And I agree with Kathy.
Can I ask you a question as we're running up against my time limit here?
Yeah.
So next week's postings compared to this week's posting, town council committees, legislative process, meetings.
No, meetings.
This
not.
Is done. Values appendix. What
and
I. And. Wow. Okay. But I'm sorry, I didn't explain that well. Liaison is done. What about ex officio? Okay.
So,
so ex officio
and
is
and
still.
Ex officio is the one where we've got two options. It is
actually
to go to the council with two options.
But and so we feel like we're done. And where is that? That isn't that in council committees?
That is in council committees.
So arguably it's still under council committee, so I can just take it out as a separate topic.
Yes.
So
yes,
I'm going to have town council committees, legislative process, and values appendix, and what did we want to call the other, the draft? Review full working draft. So town council committees, legislative process, values appendix, review full working draft, yes. Likely topics include, likely this week. I'm not doing anything with minutes today, so if the two of you are comfortable with some minutes, feel free to go ahead and a two-person vote is sufficient to make that happen, but I did not read them, so I am not going to pretend that I did. So if you've read them, great. If you haven't...
I don't even know which ones are up
for. Okay.
I didn't vote for the ones that I wrote.
I mean, I'm happy to vote aye. I just didn't even know which ones were supposed to be.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll do it next time. Who was taking minutes today? Well, you know. Chris was going to.
I got something for me.
Fun.
Maybe I'll take it right
Chris
now.
Was going
right
to.
At the beginning of that meeting. We started at 9:32. Do somebody want to adjourn us? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And we are adjourned as of 11:27 a.m.